Hello, welcome. My name is Koen Stein. I'm a paleontologist, and we are here in the Belgian Royal Institute of Natural Sciences with an exclusive in the cage of the Bernissart Iguanodons. Now, these dinosaurs, they were found in 1878 in a coal mine, more than 300 meters below the surface. What is so peculiar about these animals? Well, at their time, they were the best discovery of dinosaurs, and they really improved our understanding of dinosaurs at the time. Now, we have about 30 individuals. Most of them are these quite robust and big individuals. So you would notice that they're about 10, 15 meters in length, and they have really massive, massive bones. Now, as I said, most of them are of this size. There are two to three individuals which are of a somewhat smaller stature. And this is what I would like to show you next. So if we walk over to the other end of the cage, we can see here. So here we've arrived at one of the smaller individuals in the Bernissart Iguanodon collection. As you can see immediately that it is significantly smaller than the other specimens. People have speculated a lot about what this means. If you find an association of so many different skeletons, is this a juvenile of the same species? Or perhaps is it a different species? And there are several ways of trying to find out whether this is a different species or not. It's by looking at general characters on the skeleton, like for example the number of vertebrae in the sacrum here. How many vertebrae can you see? But the problem with a lot of these characters is that they change as animals grow. They change, so the proportions become different as well. And this is why we have taken a very small sample of one of the bones of this individual and compared it with those of the big ones. So we can take the sample and study it under the microscope and try to find out about the growth of the bones. And we concluded from this study that, in fact, this individual was already fully grown when it died. So this is most likely a different species that was living among the other Iguanodon bernissartensis.